horrifying journey. My name is Sonu and I'm your horror guide for the day. I kindly request you to fasten your seatbelts and widen your eyes because the beauty you're going to see today, you must have never seen before. India not only has rich cultural stories to tell, but also some really spooky ones. This monument has been declared of national importance under the Asian Monuments and Archaeological Sites and Remains Act 1958. Whoever destroys, removes, or disorders this monument shall be punishable with an imprisonment of 3 months or fine up to 5,000. And yes, for those whose blood doesn't run cold by the mention of ghosts, okay, now we are starting off with our journey to a place where ghosts are waiting for you. How many of you have been to this place before? How many of you heard rumors about this place? A fort. It's the Bhangar Fort. Bhangar Fort is located on the way to Alwar in Jaipur in Rajasthan. It is known for its ruins, but still worth a visit. The place is beautiful and tranquil. What remains though is the shadow of a once beautiful kingdom. The story of Bhangar began in the year 1573 when the fortress was established and built by Raja Bhupindas, the ruler of the city of Amrit. The decline of the fort continued until 1630 when Chadar Singh and Maga Singh got killed in a violent attack. It is said that the city of Bhangar was cursed by Guru Balunath, causing the town's evacuation. Balunath sanctioned the establishment of the town but said, "The moment the shadows of your palaces touch me, the city shall be known." Ignorant of such dissent, an ambitious descendant raised the palace to such a height that it shadowed Balunath's forbidden retreat. And thus, the town was devastated as professed. It is said that whoever has spent a night in the fort never returned home. No, 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 do not take a selfie or a dust, because you never know that you're posing for a picture with a ghost pouting behind you. The other myth is as follows. The charm of Bhangar princess Ratnavati was said to be matchless in all of Rajasthan. Being 18 years old, this princess started getting matrimonial offers from other states. In the same region lived a Tantri, a magician well versed in the occult, named Shinghai, who was desperately in love with the princess. Knowing that he would never be allowed to even see her, let alone meet her. One day, he saw the princess maid in the market buying scented oil for her. Seeing this, he got an idea by which he could meet the princess. He used his black magic and put a spell on the oil, which would hypnotize the princess by her merely touching the oil, and she would surrender herself. The princess foiled the plan though. She saw the wicked Tantri enchanting the oil, and she therefore threw it away, whereupon the flagon rolled over a stone and killed the Tantri. While dying, Shinghai cursed the palace with the death of all who dwelt in it, without any rebirth in the destinies. The very next year, there was a battle between Azabgarh and Bhangar, and Ratnavati died. Let us reveal you one more fact about this place. I know, you people will not easily believe this, but yes, it's a fact that the village households found here are without roofs, as they possess a popular belief and an experience that the moment a rooftop is built on a house, it collapses. This is one of the most haunted places in India, or I can say in the world, that would scare you. People are not allowed to spend a night in the fort for obvious reasons. It is said that whoever has spent a night in the place and never returns home. Okay, we have now reached our destination. The exit is towards the right. Hope you had an amazing journey. We'll be waiting for your next trip.